A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 3rd July, on the front page you have, won't tolerate bad behavior. PM Modi warns BJP members. So this is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi spoke at the BJP's parliamentary party meeting. This was first in this session of the house and of the government, and he did not name anyone when he said won't tolerate bad behavior, but it was obvious his reference was to Akash Vijayvargiya, who was arrested for assaulting government official. So he is an Indore MLA and son of National General Secretary Kailash Vijayvargiya. So he was arrested and released on bail last week after he assaulted a government official with a cricket bat. So this is the case. Then next is, Union Minister opposes UP move to shift 17 OBCs to SC list. So this we had seen in news earlier too. We have seen how Mayawati had raised her voice that this is not going to work, because under Article 341 of the Constitution, the power to make changes in the scheduled caste list lies only with the Parliament. The President can add, and you know, the President will notify. So here now Uttar Pradesh's proposal to merge 17 OBC communities into SC list, it says it should be done according to the High Court order, the court order. But then the court has not directed for them to be put in the SC list. So even a union minister, Thavarchand Gehlot, has said that only Parliament can do this, and he has opposed this move of the UP government. And below you have, 22 dead as wall collapses in Mumbai. So 375.2 millimeter rainfall in 24 hours has paralyzed Mumbai city. It has left many parts of the city waterlogged. And such disasters, walls collapsing and deaths have been reported. Then on page 8 you have, Mekedatu to claim 52.5 square kilometer of forest. So this is regarding the Mekedatu dam, which has been proposed by Karnataka government on Kaveri river. And if this dam is constructed, then a huge amount of forest land would also be submerged. So within the Kaveri wildlife sanctuary, you can see this is 52.5 square kilometer of forest overall, which would be needed for this project, of which 31.81 is in Kaveri wildlife sanctuary. So the sanctuary is home to several endemic or endangered species and is a key elephant and wildlife corridor too. So that would also be affected, biodiversity. If the project is given a go-ahead, we know the project has been opposed by Tamil Nadu and it has not been given a go-ahead yet, though Karnataka government has undertaken the detailed project report which it has submitted to the centre and has asked for its approval. On page 9 you have, government bats for sharing biological research data. So a draft note from the government on use and sharing of biological data requires researchers who collect such data and use public funds for the same to ensure that this data is made public within 2 years at the latest. So this is a draft document of the government called Biological Data Storage, Access and Sharing Policy of India. So it is primarily to address the long-standing view that, you know, among many scientists, that several scientists use government funds to conduct research and collect biological specimen and data such as RNA samples, cell, tissue samples, and store these details in databases and often lock them up, sometimes for good, means they are not available to anyone, barring access to other researchers and scientists who may be interested in them. So now this would be required to be made public within 2 years. On the editorial page, the first editorial is teachers and quotas. So this is regarding bill on reservation in central academic cadre. So it says this provides relief to disadvantaged sections. So this is to overcome the effect of the court verdict. So here you can see the center's bill actually for, it's called Central Educational Institutions Reservation in Teachers Cadre Bill 2019. So it has been passed by Lok Sabha. Earlier an ordinance was promulgated in March 2019 for the same, and now it has been replaced, ordinance has been replaced by this, will be replaced by this bill once passed by both the houses. So what it does is to restore the system of treatment of an institution or a university as a single unit to apply the reservation roster. We had seen this issue. The Allahabad High Court had struck down University Grants Commission's regulations that treated institutions as a unit. So what the Allahabad High Court had ruled was that each department to be relevant. So each department should be treated as a unit. That is, reservation should be department wise and not institution wise. But then what happened because of this is that when quota was applied department wise, so in a particular department says there are two vacancies or three vacancies, then in with reservation, if reservation for OBC is 27%, SC 15%, ST 7.5%, so then how would it be applied for such less number of seats? So they were not represented then. So in such two or three reservations in department, two or three vacations, vacant seats in department, then what is how many seats OBC would get? It would be in percentage, and if less than 1%, one, then it does not come up to one seat as such. So then they could not be allotted seats. So that's what has been seen, that department wise reservation is not working in favor of the reserved community. So that is why institution wise reservation, that overall in the institution there should be this much percentage of OBCs, that would give them more seats and better representation. So that is why the Allahabad High Court's order was reversed as such through the ordinance, and now this bill which has been proposed. So of course it is said the court was not manifestly wrong in applying the roster based on smaller unit. So of course department wise representation would also be good, but then it did not work practically. Then this is Trump in North Korea. So US President Donald Trump, appears to be committed to diplomacy in dealing with North Korea. He recently met the North Korean leader at the demilitarized zone between North and South Korea, and he's said to be the only American president to have visited North Korea. So, a sitting American president. The lead article, reclaiming the space of nonviolence. So it says, the article says, civil society must reinvent Gandhi as a political philosopher in the struggle against violence that has crushed solidarities. So violence is being seen presently in the form of lynching, and attacks even on government officials. So what needs to be done is that Gandhi needs to be reinvented in the struggle against violence. And this is not by wishful thinking. So this is a $5 trillion Indian economy may be attainable if domestic saving and investments are stepped up. So government wants to make India a $5 trillion economy by 2024. But then for that, how realistic it can be and how can this be achieved? So of course, the domestic saving rate is said to be quite low. And even investments need to be given a boost so that India achieves this target which has been put forth. So this was what Prime Minister Narendra Modi put forth as an economic target for India at a Niti Aayog meeting. On the op-ed page you have, no home even a decade after the war. So this is regarding Sri Lanka. So LTT was eliminated, the civil war ended, but it is said even after a decade now, the Indian and Sri Lankan governments still have work to do. They need to speed up voluntary repatriation of Tamil refugees too. So there are Tamil population here in Sri Lanka which may want to come back. So this is talking of repatriation of Tamil refugees. And this is healthcare's primary problem. So this article says that it is imperative to promote community-based care rather than relying on hospital services. So this is even in the context of AES deaths which have taken place in Bihar, which could have easily been preventable. Then on page 12 you have, Congress seeks Lok Sabha post. So Congress has called for the post of leader of the opposition in the Lok Sabha to be going to the party's chief whip in the house, Kudikunnil Suresh. So it says Congress was technically eligible for the post, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi should accord it the position if he was sincere about his comments on the opposition, that we need a strong opposition. Then next is, Supreme Court seeks Centre's view on Jairam Ramesh's petition. So Rajya Sabha MP Jairam Ramesh has filed a special leave petition in the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court is seeking government's response on the same. So this is a petition against February 28 decision of the Delhi High Court rejecting his challenge to amendments enacted to the Prevention of Money Laundering Act of 2015. So these provisions were through finance acts and were passed as money bills. So Mr. Jairam Ramesh, he said that the Prevention of Money Laundering Act was amended on various occasions through ordinary bills, but then in 2015 the act was being amended through money bill. So money bill is one which contains only provisions dealing with or related to monetary measures. So this bill and it money is appropriated from Consolidated Fund of India and taxation. So then in such cases it's a money bill. But money bill is restricted only to specific matters, cannot include within its ambit any other matter that is specifically mentioned in the constitution. However, final decision whether the bill is a money bill or not is with the speaker of the house, the presiding officer of the house. So that is why now here the question arises whether such bills can be passed as money bills or not. And the Delhi High Court had rejected Jairam Ramesh's challenge. So he has approached the Supreme Court on a special leave petition. Then on page 13, you have Assam deportations to be data driven. So this is regarding e-foreigners tribunals, which would be established and they will store biometrics to help speed up detection of undocumented migrants. So this is an enabling platform that digitized records of all persons who have been declared foreigners would be placed. So the NRC has been published by the end of July 2019. So these e-foreigners tribunals will store the biometrics such as fingerprints, iris scans of such persons who have been declared foreigners. Then this is Senate bill grants India NATO ally like status. So this is US Senate which has passed a legislative provision that brings India at par with America's NATO allies and countries such as Israel and South Korea for increasing defense cooperation. Then below you have Supreme Court seeks Election Commission's response on cash transfer schemes. So there is a petition which has been filed in the Supreme Court to prohibit such cash transfer schemes during polls. So we had seen how the government had initiated this cash transfer scheme for farmers too. So that is PM Kisan Samman Nidhi scheme. So that was announced during the election time and it was made effective retrospectively, and one part of the payment was made at that time itself. So this is a petition which has been filed in the Supreme Court that asking for prohibiting such schemes during elections. Then on international page you have US branch Balochistan Liberation Army terrorist group. So US has designated the militants fighting Pakistani rule in Balochistan as terrorists after it carried out deadly attacks targeting Chinese interests. Then on business page you have lithium ion giga units mooted. So lithium ion batteries are the ones which are used in electric vehicles, and electric mobility has to be given a boost in the country. Niti Aayog government think tank has now proposed establishment of giga factories in India for manufacturing of lithium ion batteries. Then this is center ratifies convention to curb company profit shifting. So this is a bit to prevent firms from moving profit out of the country. So base erosion and profit shifting, which is the international agreement to curb such practices. So this has been ratified, multilateral convention to implement tax treaty related measures to prevent base erosion and profit shifting. So this has been ratified by Indian government. On page 16, you have Apex Court's decision to reject Department of Telecom plea may help Reliance Communications buyers. So Supreme Court has upheld telecom dispute settlement, as such appellate tribunal order that liabilities of past dues rest with the telecom, not with the buyer. Then there's no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.